So welcome back. I'll just wait for 2-3 minutes before starting the class. হ্যাঁ বলো শুভম।
হ্যাঁ বলছি, জুন এন্ডে পরীক্ষা হচ্ছে তো? তাহলে মানে অ্যাসাইনমেন্টের কথা বলছেন উনি, এমনি পরীক্ষা হবে তো একটা?
ঠিক আছে, আমি এখনই এটা ডিসকাস করছি। এমডি তোমাদের সঙ্গে একটু মিট করবে। এই মুহূর্তে আমাদের ডিপার্টমেন্টাল লেভেলে, ইউনিভার্সিটি লেভেলে মিটিং হচ্ছে। আচ্ছা, যেটা হচ্ছে যে অ্যাজ সুন অ্যাজ সামথিং ইজ ফাইনালাইজড উই উইল ইনফর্ম ইউ। এখনো ইউনিভার্সিটি লেভেলে ফাইনাল ডিসিশন নেওয়া হয়নি, দ্যাট ইজ ওয়ান থিং। দ্য সেকেন্ড থিং ইজ দ্যাট দ্য ওয়ে দ্য থিংস আর গোয়িং, আই থিঙ্ক ইউ শুড প্রিপেয়ার ফর অনলাইন এক্সামস। কিভাবে এটা করব সেগুলো একটু তোমাদের সঙ্গে আমরা আলোচনা করব। Every teacher will discuss it with you separately. We will give you a course. We will discuss how the paper will be set and evaluated. But you should be mentally prepared for online assignment.
And so, like, what sir? Would be the tentative date for that exam, if any? মানে month.
হ্যাঁ, তোমাদের ক্ষেত্রে মানে আই ডোন্ট থিঙ্ক উইল হ্যাভ ইট ইন মে। একটা রুটিন করে তোমাদের দিয়ে দেবো আমরা, যেটা আমরা করব যে ছোট ছোট করে পরীক্ষা নেব, সো দ্যাট দ্য কোর্স ফর ইচ অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট ইজ লেস। মানে পুরো মাইক্রোর ওপর কোনো পেপার অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট হবে না। যেটা হবে, আমি আমার পোর্শনটাকে ডিভাইড করে নেব এবং এক একটা পোর্শনের উপর আল হ্যাভ সেপারেট অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট।
So assignments and online exams are like two different things you're saying, right? Or like are the same things?
No, technically online exam hoche, je, I'll give you the paper and I'll monitor what you're doing.
Yeah.
So I'll be watching you.
Yeah.
Sheita ami amra korte parbo na. So it will be some sort of a, ami at least jeta bhebechi, it will be some sort of an open book system. I'll give you some time. You have to submit it within that time.
Sir?
Haan.
Sir, UGC guidelines onujayi ora bolechilo je online assessment hole ar kichuta percentage of marks previous sem thekeo newa hobe. Seta ki amader hobe?
Eta hocche university decision.
Okay, sir.
Mane যা হবে সেটা প্রত্যেকটা ডিপার্টমেন্টের জন্য হবে
ওকে স্যার থ্যাঙ্ক ইউ
উই ফিল দ্যাট ইটস নট ইট ওন্ট বি ফেয়ার ফর সার্টেন রিজনস বাট আই ডোন্ট থিঙ্ক উইল বি মানে হোয়াট এভার ইউনিভার্সিটি ডিসাইডস উইল হ্যাভ টু গো অ্যালং উইথ ইট
ওকে স্যার থ্যাঙ্ক ইউ
তোমরা কি চাইবে
চাইবো না
হ্যাঁ এখন একটা জিনিস হচ্ছে ঠিক আছে দেখা যাক কি হয় উইল গিভ আওয়ার ইনপুটস আর যাদের ধরো অনলাইন অ্যাক্সেস নেই তাদের জন্য একটা আলাদা টাইম দেওয়া হবে সো আফটার দ্য ইউনিভার্সিটি রিওপেন্স দে ক্যান কাম অ্যান্ড সাবমিট দ্য অ্যাসাইনমেন্টস এইভাবে ভাবা হচ্ছে সো দে উইল হ্যাভ আ সেপারেট অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট ঠিক আছে আমি তাহলে এখন স্টার্ট করে দিচ্ছি ইউ ক্যান সি দ্য স্ক্রিন এভরিওয়ান
ইয়েস
ওকে Hopefully by next week. মানে আমরা ধরে নিচ্ছি যে অনলাইন অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট হবে সেই মতো প্রিপেয়ার করছি এই মুহূর্তে আমরা সেটা তোমাদের সঙ্গে শেয়ার করতে মানে অতটা কমিউনিকেট করতে চাইছি না কারণ উই আর ওয়েটিং ফর দ্য ইউনিভার্সিটি ডিসিশন Once university informs us, ekdom formally tomake janiye amra egobo. But be prepared mentally. Shei dikhei jacche trend ta. And you will be given time. Mane emon noy je ache kalkei tomader online assignment hobe. Tomader course deya hobe, schedule deya hobe, tarpor online assignment start korbo. Okay, so the last topic in microeconomics was information economics, and we were discussing the second unit, which was adverse selection. Now, in information economics, the main problem is that in trade, we normally assume that both parties have perfect information. Now, if you want to incorporate uncertainty, then this assumption is violated. But again, in the case of uncertainty, you have both parties have an equal disadvantage. In information economics, we are not talking about this type of disadvantage. We are talking about a particular type of disadvantage, which is asymmetric. So in other words, either the producer or supplier or the consumer or the person who is buying the commodity, one of these two parties have more information than the other party. Such asymmetric information can happen because of hidden information and because of hidden action. Now, in case of whenever this asymmetric information occurs, we can have two types of problem. One is that people become reluctant to trade. So the optimal volume of trade will decrease. And further, what will happen is, if you think of two types of products, good quality and bad quality, then it is the bad quality products which will be supplied. So the bad quality products will drive out the good quality products. And in the limiting case, you'll have a market with only bad quality or lemons. Once we decide to trade, then the problem of moral hazard emerges. In moral hazard, there's a decision to trade, but because the contract is incomplete, one party can decide to cheat on the other party. So he agrees to do something, but either doesn't do it properly or doesn't provide the same amount of work, or provides an action, does an action which is not appropriate, as a result of which his utility is maximized, but the person who has commissioned him to do the work gets adversely affected. So moral hazard occurs before trade. Sorry, adverse selection occurs before trade. Moral hazard occurs after the contract is made. So we had discussed different types of adverse selection situations. The first was the second-hand cars, where the producer has more information than the consumer. In case of the insurance market, it is the opposite. The company, insurance company, has less information, than the producer or supplier. So the person who is buying the insurance has more information. The insurance company, the supplier, has less information. Now, if you have adverse selection, then one way of circumventing the problem is through signaling. This was pointed out by Michael Spence in his book, Signaling, published in 1973. So signals is an indication which can be observed by everyone, which indicates that the producer is selling a high quality product. The core of signaling is that signaling is costly. Therefore, it is only those producers who are providing the high quality product or services, only these people or these agents can afford to make the signal. For instance, if you're offering guarantees that if the product is bad, you will replace it within 1 year. See, if you are selling fake products, can you give this guarantee? If it's a fake product, then it's very likely that within 2-3 months, everyone will come and return the product. But if you are supplying a good quality product, then you can afford to make this guarantee. You know that the product is of a good quality, therefore it will work perfectly for 2-3 years. So during the warranty period, there will not be any complaint about the product. So you can have different type of signaling. One type is cheap talk. In cheap talk, the agent makes a claim which cannot be substantiated. So we cannot verify whether the agent makes a statement that he's a good quality or bad quality product. And you cannot verify whether he's telling the truth or not. That is why we call it cheap talk. So we showed that cheap talk can, in some cases, result in a very optimal equilibrium. The applicant will tell the truth. This, however, is not always true. In this payoff matrix, for instance, it is to the benefit of the agent to tell the truth. If he's high quality, he will see his high quality and vice versa. But in this case, he will not make a true statement. Both workers will claim that they are high quality. So in that case, you have pooling equilibrium. So pooling equilibrium is a situation when the worker does not distinguish between high quality and low quality. He simply pays them an average wage. How do we find the average wage? It is a weighted average. WH is the wage of high quality. WL is the wage to low quality workers. And X is the proportion of high quality workers in the market. So this is the formula by which he will find out the average wage, and he is going to pay every worker this wage irrespective of whether the worker is high quality or low quality. So this is pooling equilibrium. Everyone is pooled or treated the same. Another type of equilibrium is separating equilibrium, when the high quality workers are identified through a signal and they are paid WH. The remaining workers are obviously WL and they are paid WL wages. So this is possible in a, education is a possible type of signal, but education as a cost, and depending on the parameter values, you can have either a separating equilibrium or you can have a pooling equilibrium. Now today I'm going to start with efficiency wage theory. Efficiency wage theory attempts to explain why there's unemployment and why there's wage discrimination, why we pay different wages to different workers. Now, the productivity of labor is determined by three factors. One is the ability of the worker, his innate skill. The second is the firm's investment, that is capital stock. And thirdly, the wage rate. Why? Because a high wage rate means that the income of the worker is also high. Therefore, the worker can consume nutritious food and his productivity will increase. So in developing countries, if you pay low wages, this is going to lead to nutritional problems and this will lower productivity of the worker. Now, in developed countries, this efficiency wage theory argues that if you pay low wages, this can lead to a different type of problem. It can lead to the principal agent problem, with the agent shirking or not offering his full labor, not putting in his full effort. Let's see how this occurs. We assume that markets are perfectly competitive, so all workers are equally productive and they earn the same wage. Once you have...
Sir,
wage rate money take it to me. এক ঘন্টায় বা একদিনে কত টাকা পাচ্ছ?
ওটাই
হ্যাঁ কোনখানে ছিল এখানে তোমাকে যদি আমি ডেইলি ওয়েজটা কম দিই ঠিক আছে তাহলে তোমার ইনকামটা লো হচ্ছে ইয়োর কনজাম্পশন লেভেল উইল অলসো ফল অ্যান্ড ইউ উইল হ্যাভ ম্যাল নিউট্রিশন So this efficiency wage theory shows that low wages can lead to another problem. So this is what I'm going to discuss now. So we have the same type of workers, but once you hire them, so you offer them work, the workers can choose between either putting in the full effort so they work properly, or they can slack. So they don't put in the full effort. The problem, however, is that the producer cannot observe them. So the producer doesn't know whether the worker is working properly or whether he's slacking. If they had perfect information, if the producers knew that, let us say, the fourth worker is slacking, then they would simply tell him that, okay, you leave the job. They would fire him. But the problem is, because for whatever reason, because they are working in a team or they are working in different places, what happens is we cannot observe what they are doing, and so some of them may be slacking. So there are various ways in which we can stop this. Now, this is the diagram that we have. So this is the demand for labor, and this is the supply for labor, and the equilibrium is given by this. This is the demand for labor, DL, and this dotted line is the supply of labor. So at any point of time, supply of labor is fixed. See, this is SL and this is DL. So what is the equilibrium? It will be this point where the demand and supply curve intersects. So the wage rate is W star and all the workers will be employed. Is this clear, everyone? Shoham, arekbar bolbo? Now we have two cases. You have a Now we consider two cases. In the first case, but just suppose in general that there are 10 firms in the economy. In case one, only one firm faces the problem of slacking or shirking. So in the remaining nine firms, there's no problem. All the workers work efficiently. So we assume that at the market clearing wage, W star, where demand and supply are equal, workers have the incentive to shirk. Now, in this case, the producer can give a threat that I will fire you. If you don't work properly, I'm going to fire you. In that case, what will happen? If the labor is fired, he will simply leave the company and join another firm. Right? You have a situation of full employment. So the threat that I'm going to fire you is not very effective. Do you understand this point?
Please repeat this point.
Sorry?
Could you please repeat the second point?
Okay. So what is happening is that, let us say you are not working properly. So I come up to you and say that, okay, you leave the firm. Now, if you have full employment in the economy, what does it mean? If any worker is unemployed or thrown out of one firm, he will immediately get another job in another firm. Right? And his wage rate is going to be the same, W star. Everyone is getting W star. So in this situation, if I threaten to throw you out, will the threat be effective?
No.
It will not be effective because I'm not able to impose any cost on you.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you repeat this one from the beginning? I didn't understand this.
This slide?
Yes, sir. Case one.
Your voice is clear, Huchena.
Sir, I'm saying that can you repeat case one from the beginning?
Okay, thik ache. Okay, so let us say we have 10 firms, okay? And we are discussing the problem from the perspective of the first firm. I'm the producer and I've hired all of you. Okay, now after I've hired you, I'm going to pay you a wage of W star, right? Now, if I pay you W star, you will want to slack, not work properly. And somehow I find it out that you're not working properly. So how can I stop this slacking? I can say that if you don't work properly, then I'm going to throw you out. Okay.
Yes, sir.
What happens if I throw you out? If you have full employment, you are simply going to join another firm. And that firm also is going to pay you W star.
So when you say full employment, you mean that the economy is running under full employment, right?
Yes.
Like, yeah, okay.
Yeah. So whatever, if anyone is unemployed, he's always going to get some work. And he's going to get it without any search cost. So if I throw you out today at 12 o'clock, at 12:01, you are going to get work. Yeah. Kono waiting cost nahi, kono search cost nahi. You are immediately going to get work and at the same wage, W star. So in this case, you'll simply move from one firm to another. Getting thrown out doesn't have any impact on you. So I'm not really punishing you, right?
Yes.
So in this case, simply the threat will not impose any fear or will not have any effect. So how can I stop you from shirking? In that case, the firm will offer a higher wage. Let's see, you have a higher wage. So that, let us go back to the earlier slide. So instead of paying every worker W star, I pay you a wage of WL. WL is above the market wage rate. Clear? Now, if you are thrown out of work, you were getting WL, but if you go to another firm, you will be employed immediately. But now you get a wage of W star. Right? So now, what is your choice? You can either work hard. In that case, you will get WL. If you don't work hard, then you are going to get thrown out and you'll be employed by another firm, but at a lower wage of W star. Right? So in this case, shirking has a cost. In the previous case, if you work hard, you got W star. If you didn't work hard, you were thrown out, you still got W star from another firm. But now, getting thrown out imposes a cost on the worker. So if the difference in wage is large, the workers will be induced to be productive, right? So basically, I'm offering a choice. If you work hard, I'm going to pay you 1,000 rupees. If you don't work hard, then you have to shift to another firm when you will get, let us say, 600. Right? In this case, the incentive is to be to work hard. Now, suppose you get, I offer you the market wage is 600, and I offer you 605. Is it a large difference? It will not have an impact. So you'll have to increase wage rate substantially above 600. And the wage at which there's no shirking is called the efficiency wage. Okay, so this WL is the efficiency wage. Okay, at this point, there's no shirking. Now, suppose all firms have to face the same problem. So all firms will offer the efficiency wages, WE, which is greater than the market wage rate. So in that case, will it remove the incentive for workers? See, what will happen is, in that case, if they get thrown out, they will simply be hired. See, all the firms are paying WE. So if you get thrown out of work, you'll be re-employed at WE. Sorry. Made a mistake. Okay. Again, you have to go back. Yeah. So now we are assuming that all the firms pay W. This is, I thought it was WL, it's WE, efficiency wage. So if all firms are paying WE, then this is the demand for labor. You will have labor employed up to LE. So this is not full employment. You have an unemployment of L star minus LE. Okay.
Sir, তাহলে কি full employment economy-তে exist করছে না করছে না?
এখন আর করছে না.
মানে কেস ওয়ানে করছিল তাই তো?
কেস ওয়ানে করছিল. If I'm paying W star, then I have full employment.
আচ্ছা. Okay, okay.
If all the firms are paying WL, then obviously they are going to hire less workers.
Less workers. Okay.
So it will not be a full employment situation. You will have unemployment of this amount, L star minus LE.
But in case one, we won't face any unemployment.
In case one, only one firm is facing the problem.
Yes.
So the remaining N firms can pay W star, and for some whatever reason, all the workers will work efficiently. So only one firm is offering WE. So okay. Here we will have full employment. Okay, in the first case. In the second case, if all the firms are offering WE, then this will reduce the aggregate demand for labor. It will be less than the market clearing quantity and there will be unemployment. So now what happens is there's competition for jobs. If you work hard, you will be retained by the company and you will still get WE. But if you don't work hard, then you will be identified and you will be thrown out of work. When a person is thrown out of work, then he cannot get employment at WE. Because all the total demand for firms is now less. So what we can do is we can define a no shirking constraint, which is defined as the lowest wage that firm can pay. so that there's no slacking off. So this is the upward sloping curve. And WE can be found out when this intersects with the demand for labor curve. Okay, so the equilibrium will occur at WE with LE workers. Okay, so this is the wage rate that will be paid. This is LE. So the workers are induced to work hard by the fear of unemployment. They are paid a higher wage if they decide to shirk or slack. Then they are going to lose this wage rate. They will get simply zero because they are unemployed. So an example, the efficiency wages.
Yeah, I guess example to boy na yes tutor.
বোঝানোর টাইম নেই তাহলে আমি কেটে দিচ্ছি কেটে আবার আমি জয়েন করছি ঠিক আছে